question has been illustrated by an incident which occurred during the lifetime of the promised Messiah alayhi salam. The question starts as follows, poor people usually are not respected in society, but the promised Messiah alayhi salam had paid particular attention to their welfare, to be kind to them, etc. And the incident of Mian Nizamuddin Sahib, when the promised Messiah alayhi salam was sitting on the roof of Masjid Mubarak on one occasion, and there were just a few people there with them, and Mian Nizamuddin Sahib was one of them. And little by little, more people were coming in who were more influential in the worldly way of seeing things. And little by little, Mian Nizamuddin Sahib was going backward, moving backwards towards the shoes.
Was forced to move.
Yes, he had to, yes. So finally what happened was that the promised Messiah alayhi salam took a bowl of curry food and bread, and he called Mian Sahib and said, let's go to the room on one side and we'll eat together. So in this way he could see that Mian Nizamuddin Sahib was poor, because his clothes, it was reported, were quite tattered and torn. Now the question is that usually Muslims do not like to show that they're poor. They try to keep their bodies, you know, well covered, etc., in good clothes. So how can we tell, are there any means that we could tell that they're poor?
You know, this whole episode seems to be misread by Salima, because the inference she is drawing is not the inference which should be drawn. First of all, any person should be dressed in the whatever clothes God has blessed him with. Only the difference between a Muslim and a non-Muslim should be that whether you are dressed in rags, they should be clean rags. And that has been throughout the tradition of Sahaba, Radwanullah alayhim, that whatever clothes they were always clean. They were not filthy. And they washed them almost daily, or kept them clean anyway, because they knew the importance of coming to God in clean clothes. Whether they said tahajjud in the house or appeared in the mosque, they understood the Quranic version that you should always wear clean clothes, not expensive clothes. They're two different things. So a poor man can be recognized by the clothes he's wearing, and yet the clothes should be clean. And they were clean in the case of Mian Nizamuddin Sahib. Nobody says that he was wearing dirty clothes. Secondly, the episode is misread in another way. It doesn't mean that whenever you are in a feast, you will find out who is the poorest and go and sit with him. And if this is what is the meaning of this, then every feast will be put into a great disorder. Everybody is looking for a poorer man so that he can fulfill this verses. This is not the case. It has a completely different message. In fact, Mian Nizamuddin Sahib was shown arrogance by some people who were behaving more arrogantly. And we know the characters of those who were present, and we can understand who it was. Particularly, who showed his greatness and his arrogance by coming forward while Mian Nizamuddin was sitting in front. Nobody had a right to push him back. So people who worldly-wise thought themselves big people, they did it. Hazrat Masih Maud Sa'd Waslam had a very kind disposition. He did not pinpoint these people and show their arrogance and reveal their arrogance in public. So that was his way of showing his anger. He didn't like it at all. He was very unhappy. So when he asked Mian Nizamuddin to come and sit with me, all these arrogant people were abandoned. So this is the inference of this episode, which is right, and it is drawn like this.